We already knew that the recent G20 summit in Buenos Aires, Argentina was going to be full of opportunities for Donald Trump to make a complete ass of himself once again on the world stage. We just didn't know it was going to happen so quickly. It's understandable that Trump would be ill-prepared for the all-important meeting of world leaders. Not only is he terrible at his job to begin with, but the fact of the matter is, he has a lot on his plate right now. After his former lawyer rocked the Russia probe with a new early morning guilty plea in which he admitted to lying to federal investigators about the duration of a real estate project in Moscow and just how much involvement then-candidate Trump had in it, the president was faced with finding innovative ways to try and spin his way out of what will almost certainly end in indictments for not just him but his children as well. But distraction is no excuse when you're the president of the United States. And that means it's still pretty embarrassing to watch him stumble around like an 8-year-old wearing his dad's shoes. First on the agenda, looking like an idiot in front of the leader of the host country. Standing next to Argentine President Mauricio Macri that Friday, Trump listened as he was praised in Spanish by the diplomatic leader. But things went quickly off the rails as Trump suddenly threw his earpiece, which had someone translating Spanish, into English for him on the ground. He didn't, of course. Trump does not speak Spanish. He simply was overcome by frustration with hearing Macri speak so closely to him while he simultaneously tried to understand the English translation, and in fairness, he doesn't speak that language all that well either. More importantly, however, it was a stark reminder that, as he went on to speak to Macri in English, claiming to have known him for many years, Trump doesn't actually care if anyone else is having difficulty understanding him at all.